The attack appears depressingly similar to several others in recent years in France. On March 23, a young man, reportedly of North African origin and of declared allegiance to the so-called Islamic State, spread terror by shooting random unarmed victims, the occupants of a passing car in the southwestern town of Carcassonne, policemen out jogging, and finally shoppers in a supermarket in Trèbes, a village of 5,000 people a few kilometers to the east. He might have imagined the police would be slow to react in such a small community. The attacker, who screamed Allahu Akbar, God is great, as he went about his work, tried to prolong the assault by taking hostages, a tactic used by other violent extremists in France and elsewhere, most notably at the Bataclan Theater in Paris in November 2015, where 90 people died. The goal, in such cases, appears to be to attract as much attention as possible, and to stir up public frustration if police are slow to respond. This time, the reaction was relatively swift. By mid-afternoon, 3 hours after the first reported shots, police had killed the gunman at the supermarket. By then, 3 people, besides the attacker, were reported dead, and several more injured. Get our daily newsletter, upgrade your inbox, and get our daily dispatch and editor's picks. The French authorities have long been concerned that lone attackers, radicalized either through visits to Syria's civil war or at home by exposure to extremism online, are hard to spot before they act. President Emmanuel Macron, speaking after the gunman was killed, talked of a persistent terrorist menace in the country, as dangerous individuals are influenced by Islamic State or other exterior forces. Ministers named the gunman as Redouane Lakhdim, a 26-year-old. It was not clear how he had been radicalized, nor if he had been on a police watch list. For Mr. Macron, who became president last year, this was the most serious test of how his government handles an attack, and the first since France lifted its 719-day-long state of emergency, imposed after Bataclan, last November. Last October, a man who also claimed allegiance to Islamic State stabbed 2 young women to death at Marseille train station. Police promptly shot him. 3 attacks in Paris, in June and August, led to injuries but no deaths, other than that of one of the perpetrators. Young president has mostly taken a muscular approach to violent extremists. Unlike his predecessor, François Hollande, Mr. Macron does not talk of conducting war against terrorism, but he does promote tough security measures that, say opinion polls, are popular. Operation Sentinel, which involves the deployment of 10,000 heavily armed soldiers on streets, is widely liked. An anti-terrorism law, passed last November to replace the state of emergency, made permanent some of the government's emergency powers. For example, the Interior Ministry, rather than judges, now has the final say on orders restricting the movements of suspects. Officials, not courts, can order the closure of places of worship deemed suspect. Mr. Macron has also promised the security services more resources. He pledged last year that France will have 10,000 extra police by 2022, and in June a new intelligence center coordinating efforts against extremists was set up in the Élysée Palace, the president's residence and office. The new National Center for Counterterrorism, led by a former chief of counterespionage, Pierre Bousquet de Florian, is supposed to have made French officialdom more professional and dealing with threats. As ever, though, the security services get little attention from the public, however many attacks they foil. Supposedly over 30 were stopped while the state of emergency was in effect. Any failure to prevent an attack, though, grabs the headlines.